Hello, welcome to this week's Google Maps Developer Shortcuts. I'm coming to you from the Sydney studio, where we have new couches and I have a little more facial hair after Google I.O. Speaking of I.O., if you haven't already watched my talk, I strongly suggest you do. It's called When Android Meets Maps, and it gives you a rundown of the Google Maps Android API and some of the cool things you can do with it. So, speaking of cool things, I talked a little bit about this utility library at I.O. and today I've extended it a little bit more. So it's called the Android Maps Utils Library. It has a polyutil, a spherical util, and as of today, a Bubbleicon factory. So let's talk about polyutil just very quickly. At the moment it has one function, it's decode. It'll take an encoded polyline or polygon, which is a string. You might get this from the Google Directions API. And it'll give you back a list of latitude, longitude points. Spherical util is great if you need to do things like compute distances between points, areas, headings between two points, or simply interpolate. Perhaps you want to animate a marker between Sydney and France. You can cycle through that third value to get a nice smooth line between Sydney and France. There's many more functions. These are just a small sampling. So let's talk about Bubbleicon Factory. Essentially, it just lets you generate marker images like this. These sort of look like info windows, but each marker is always showing. So this is great for showing small snippets of information, such as house prices, as you can see here. It's really simple. You just create a new Bubbleicon factory, and you call makeIcon, and you pass it a string, and that string will be shown within that marker icon. You get back a bitmap, which you can pass through to the bitmap descriptor factory, and you just add that to your marker through the icon option. Of course, you can use set icon to change that marker later. So you can change the color of it. Here you can see that we've got white markers and green markers. So you can just call set style on the factory and just say that you want a green style. You can change these styles at any time. So you can, for example, set a whole bunch of styles on the factory or maybe create separate factories for two different types of markers. It's really up to you. So the other neat thing about this is that you can rotate markers. Here you can see that we've got markers that are pointing downwards. So this is great for a small snippet of information, once again, like house prices, where you don't really want to interfere with the map too much. So we've gone a little bit crazy with colors here. You might want to stick to one or two different colors, but the library ships with a lot of different styles that might suit your application. It's just the orange, red, purple, blue, and green. So you can, as I said, you can set the rotation of the marker. You can rotate the marker itself or just the content within it. So with these markers, where the text is just pointing down, we just set the content rotation to 90 degrees. Now you could have markers that are sticking outwards, like a little tag as well. That's all quite possible. You can also change the content view completely. For instance, if you'd like to display an image within that little bubble, you can do that too. You just call set content view. Perhaps you'd want to pass an image view down to that. And instead of calling makeIcon with a string, you just call makeIcon and you get back that bitmap. So a little tip, these can be run off the main thread, off the UI thread. So you could go and generate all of these in parallel or in the background, perhaps in an async task. And once it's generated back on the UI thread, go and put that marker onto the map. So go and check it out. It's on github.com/Google Maps. It's distributed as an Android library project. Much like Action Bar Sherlock or something like that, you're probably familiar with it. Actually, in fact, you're already familiar with it if you're using the Maps API, because the Google Play Services client is distributed as a library project. So just go ahead and drop that into your project and you can start using this polyutil, spherical util, and the Bubbleicon factory. Well, I hope that helps and I'll see you around next time. Thank you.